Hey there, YouTube. Thanks so much for stopping by the channel. This is Son of Liberty. Today's product review, we're going to be discussing the Tier 1 Concealed AGIS holster, and we're going to be comparing it to its newer model. We'll also be discussing some of the enhancements that have been made to this unit to not only make it more concealable, but also more comfortable for all-day wear. So whether you are new to hearing about this product for the first time, or a seasoned consumer of the company, I believe that there's going to be information beneficial to everyone. So stay tuned, and let's take a closer look. So what we're looking at here is the older version of the AGIS holster from Tier 1. What I'd like to do is do a quick overview of the features of this model, talk about one of the features that sets it apart from its competitor. I'll also bring in the Glock 43 version so you can take a look at it, and then I'll roll in some footage to show you a comparison of the older model versus the new. Now, one of the things that probably draws your attention right off the bat is these series of buttons here. Now, this is the feature that sets it apart from its competitor. This is a piece of leather that is, of course, adorned with buttons to be able to join these two pieces together. Now, we are dealing with a clear weapon. This is just a empty magazine. But this is going to aid in several different benefits, but I'm only going to talk about one at this time. If you'll notice here, it's going to be a little hard to see, but there is some flexibility up and down because the leather gives, okay? But more so in this general direction. Now, this is going to aid in comfort as we are moving throughout the day, getting in and out of a vehicle, bending over to tie our shoe, picking something up off the ground, those types of things, okay? You'll also notice that there is a very large U-notch area here. Now, this actually aids in if we are using the pinch method to overcome the garment to get to our gun. Now, if you're unfamiliar with that terminology, I've got a very detailed video that I've done called The Art of Appendix Draw. I'll make sure to post a link in the video description down below so that you guys can check that out. Now, another benefit is because of this large area, this will give us the ability to accommodate a lot of different red dots, whether we want to run, the Leopold Delta Point, the Vortex Red Dots, Trichicon RMR, or even what is becoming more popular, the Micro T1 from Aimpoint. All right. You'll also notice that we've got injection molded plastic clips here. Now, these are actually tuckable, so if you like to run your particular setup that way, you can. And we've also got their particular version of the Raven Concealment Claw. All right, you can see that they've actually got their serrated here. Now, it's not very sharp. What this does is this just aids in applying a little bit additional grip when you go to apply pressure to the belt as you cinch this down. Now, another feature here is that we've got an open bottom. Now, whether you want to run threaded or non-threaded, the Glock 19, which I've got here, or a Glock 17, you're going to have some a variety of options when it comes to that. Now, of course, the benefit to running a particular setup like this is, let's say, for example, I'm going out for dinner with my wife, and I want to run a button-up shirt with a blazer. This, because I can take these apart if I don't want to run an appendix, I can run the mag carrier independently on the left-hand side, and then I can run this one on the 3-4 o'clock position on my strong side, okay? But now let's say, for example, I get home after dinner and I've decided I want to go watch a movie that night. Well, I like to run a light on most of my guns, but let's say, for example, I only run a light, let's say, at night for whatever reason. I can go home, go to my safe. I can go get my light-bearing gun. It's already set up and ready to go. And now I can just join these two together. And now I have my light I have my light bearing Glock ready to go. Okay, so there's a lot of flexibility to this particular type of setup. Let me just move this in out of the way here for just a few moments. And I'm going to show you the Glock 43 version. Of course, it's set up very similar. One thing that you'll notice is this is a closed bottom. All right, there's really no need for this one to be an open bottom because the Glock 43 is a particular size, and it, you know, this particular holster cannot accept larger Glocks because of the size of the 43. It is unique to that model. So, anyway, just wanted to show you that. All right, guys, so I've got the newer version out here on the table, and I just wanted to go over some of the benefits of this one versus the old one. On the old one here, let me mention a few things. The belt clips themselves are actually very tough, all right? It actually made it a little difficult to get these over the belt, and especially if you were going to run your shirt tucked in, it made it a lot harder to actually get that in behind the clips themselves. That is one of the changes that they've made, and I actually like it a lot better. These are more flexible, and it makes it easier to get these on the belt and, of course, to tuck the garment in if you choose to run it that way. Another thing that you will see, of course, is the placement of the leather piece versus it starting here on the magazine carrier and connecting to here. They've essentially reversed that, but if you'll notice here that there is a much more rounded, more natural curve here versus what is on the older model. Now, as you tighten the belt here on this clip, what would happen, and you'll see that it creates a hot spot or a high point here. And what this would do is that's not a very natural curve, okay? And so it, depending on the type of garment that you were wearing, it would actually print a little bit. These clips also printed a little bit more because they are thicker, all right? Another thing that you'll see here is the change in the angle. And what this would actually do is this did not conceal the grip of the gun quite as well as this particular style of angle does. This provides a much better angle to pull this into. It actually aids in pulling the stock in closer to your stomach. All right. So I'm going to roll in some footage here so that you guys can see a little bit detailed close-up of the differences of the newer model versus the old. We'll be right back. So needless to say, guys, I am very impressed with this holster. I've not had any types of issues whatsoever. You know, I thought that when I started testing the holster, I thought that I may have some issues during wear and doing training or bending over, doing certain types of things, that the buttons would come unseated, and I have not had any issues whatsoever. So total combined testing time, I've actually had a little over 4 months of total time on this particular platform. So the newer model as well as the old. And so I can tell you this, there is a huge difference in comfort with this newer model versus the old one. I could tell immediately as soon as I put this one on how much more comfortable that it was. So again, the longest I've tested this system is for 15 hours in 1 day. And that was, I've got a secondary job, and so I got up at 5 o'clock that morning, drove several hours to meet a guy, worked for about 10 hours, drove several hours back, and then I had to do some things that night, but I have not had any issues whatsoever, with this particular system. I believe that you guys will be very impressed with it. All right, guys, that's going to wrap up this video review. If you are not a subscriber, please make sure to click that subscribe button. I would love to have you on board. And to all of my subscribers, thank you so much for your continued support. I couldn't grow the channel without you. Stay tuned. I've actually got a 4-day event weekend coming up with Tactical Gentlemen out of Georgia. I think there's going to be a lot to be seen and a lot of cool stuff planned for that event weekend. So, guys, until the next time, take care. Be safe.